أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Sir Iqbal Taqrani, respected ulama, my brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh, and good evening. I want to say to you that it is an enormous inspiration to be in London tonight, to be amongst Muslims in their thousands, and to draw inspiration from you as you chart a course, not only for yourselves and your families, but for Muslims in Britain, for Muslims in Europe, for Muslims in the West, because tonight you are showing us what we are capable of as we go forward. I want to say to you that I come from a country, South Africa, where Muslims have been present in that country for over 300 years. I want to say to you that we are a community that have understood what it means to suffer, because we were brought there into Cape Town, into South Africa, as slaves to do the work of the colonialists. We came there as exiles when we opposed colonialism in Java, in Indonesia, in Malaysia, and in places of Asia. When we were there, we were not allowed to practice our Islam. When you were caught making salah, you were put to death. When you were seen engaging in Muslim festivals, your property was confiscated. When we were able to do all the things that a Muslim must do, it was declared illegal and a criminal act. And yet for hundreds of years, our forefathers and our foremothers survived that system. And we emerged out of it. We fought colonialism and we fought apartheid. And today, alhamdulillah, Muslims find themselves in a situation. And so verily the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is true. فَإِنَّ مَعُ الْأُسْرِ يُسْرًا إِنَّ مَعُ الْأُسْرِ يُسْرًا. Out of difficulty comes ease. Verily, out of difficulty comes ease. Today, all over the world, particularly in the West, Muslims face enormous challenges. We face Islamophobia. We face the challenges of discrimination. We face the challenges of being branded. We face the challenges of being labeled terrorists and a variety of other things. I want to say to you that we too went through that in South Africa. But we have learned some very important lessons. The first one is not to elevate our suffering to exclusive victimhood. We knew that just as we were suffering, other people in the black community too were being oppressed, were being discriminated against. And we understood that unless we make common purpose with those others around us who also suffer and create solidarity, we will not be able to go forward. And so one of the important lessons that the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in South Africa learned was to hold hands with other people, whether they believe like we did, irrespective of being Christian, irrespective of being Hindu, and irrespective even of being Jewish in South Africa, we held hands with them, and irrespective of even being atheistic as we went forward. And so Muslims who were in South Africa were never afraid to hold the hands of other believers, of people of other faiths, or people of no faith. And we built up the mightiest coalition against apartheid and against colonialism. And the fact of the matter is that we were able to do that because we were not insecure about our own identity and our own belief as Muslims. We were able to be secure in that belief and to hold the hands of others. And that is a very important principle to go forward. We understood also that the answer to the exclusivism of apartheid was not to be exclusive in our understanding of being Muslim, that we needed to show Islam's capacity to embrace diversity. And those are the kind of things that we did, to respect each other, not simply to tolerate each other, but to respect each other's belief as the basis for cooperation and coexistence. We also understood that there are challenges in the world today that are not only an affront, that's not only offensive to Muslims, but he is against the belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself. And so to some extent, our common fight with others is not only for the survival of Islam, but it is for the survival of the belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by human beings as well. And so sometimes we must abandon the idea of competitive religion to move into the sphere of cooperative religions. All of us working to the glory of God, however we may worship Allah. All of us working together to solve common problems in our communities. All of us understanding where we differ, but also understanding where we have common ground.